Okay, well, it's 6:30 on the dot. So welcome to our August 3rd, 2021 council meeting. I'd like to call the meeting to order. And I'd like to start with a moment of silent reflection, please. Thank you. We'd like to acknowledge that this meeting is being held on the traditional territory of the Mississauga Nations. A couple of notices. Ontario has entered step three of the reopening roadmap as of Friday, July 16th, with COVID-19 public health measures still in effect for all Ontarians. We look forward to welcoming the community back to our recreation facilities and to offering limited modified programs and activities for residents to enjoy. As always, I remind you to check our dedicated COVID-19 webpage for impacts to our municipal services and facilities. And I'll ask our Director of Fire and Emergency Service to give us any additional COVID-19 updates.
Thank you, Deputy Mayor. I can give you a COVID update for today in our area. So within Ontario, there was 164 new cases. One of those cases was locally within Northumberland County. There's presently 7 unresolved cases in Northumberland County and a grand total of 30 within the health unit. To date, there's been 32 hospitalizations within Northumberland County. And on the good side, we've got 0 cases within Northumberland in the ICU and 0 outbreaks. With regards to vaccines, within the health unit, there is 136,414 first doses, and second doses, we're sitting roughly at 119,000. With regards to step three, and it is a reminder that we are in step three and with hopes of moving into the exit plan within the next week or two. But what we can foresee happening is there will still be a requirement for masks when indoors. Schools will be back to functioning as normal with the exception of masks indoors for children. We're going to be looking at capacity limits being lifted for the majority of businesses. And basically masks will still be required when social distancing is not achievable. And that is our COVID update for this evening, unless anyone has any questions.
Thank you, Director. Community updates. Police Chief Brian Wood has been awarded the Order of Merit of the Police Forces by the Canadian Association of Chiefs of Police in a virtual ceremony held on July 13th. This award honors the leadership an exceptional service or distinctive merit displayed by the men and women of the Canadian Police Services and recognizes their commitment to this country. On behalf of Council, we'd like to congratulate Chief Wood on this award. Also, August is Arts Month in Port Hope. The Port Hope Arts Festival is traditionally a one-day celebration in downtown Port Hope. For 2021, we are celebrating the arts all month long. You'll find a list of activities and creative self-guided events on porthope.ca/arts-festival. Okay, is there any disclosure of pecuniary interest in the nature of thereof? Seeing none, there was no closed session tonight. Point four, consent agenda. Do any council members request that specific items be removed or discussed? There is 4.1 council meeting minutes of July 6th, 2021, and 4.2 committee of the whole meeting minutes of July 6th, 2021. Do I need a mover on this?
Yes, you do. A mover and a seconder, and that can be voted on to receive those minutes, approve those minutes.
Councilor Lee, seconded by Councilor Meadows. Any discussion? All those in favor? Thank you. Point five, business from previous minutes and notification of new business. Is there any new business? Seeing none, petitions and delegations, none. 7.1, correspondence. Town of Erie regarding capital gains tax on primary residence. And I'll deliver this. Recommend that a resolution be prepared for presentation to council at the next meeting to support the resolution received from the town of Fort Erie. I think that is the recommendation. They have a mover and a seconder, please. Moved by Councillor Carr, seconded by Councillor Mink. Any discussion on this item? Seeing none, all those in favor? That's carried. Staff and committee reports. 8.1, Sonia Tam, planner, regarding extension of temporary use part of lots 30 and 31, concession 1, Wesleyville Village, and applicant, the Friends of Wesleyville Village. Recommend that the extension renewal of temporary use bylaw as submitted by the Friends of Wesleyville Village for lands located in parts of lot 30 and 31, concession 1 of the municipality portal, be referred to bylaws, and further, that the request for a refund for the temporary use extension fee from Friends of Wesleyville Village in the amount of $650 be granted by resolution. I have a mover and a seconder, please. Moved by Councillor Carr, seconded by Councillor Meadows. Any discussion on this? Councillor Mink?
No.
I'm sorry, I thought you had your hand raised. All those in favor? Thank you. 8.2, Theodore Romero Peza, manager, planning regarding development agreement 34 Percival Street, applicant, Kawartha Pine Ridge District School Board. Recommend refer to bylaws. May I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Councillor Bickle, seconded by Councillor Meadows. Is there any discussion on this item? All those in favor? Thank you. Consent agenda. Are there any resolutions that council members would like to review separately on this? Seeing none, 9.1, 45/21. Recommendation from Works and Engineering, July 6, 2021. Water System Financial Plan for Ontario Regulation 453/07. Have a mover and a seconder, please. Moved by Councillor Meadows, seconded by Councillor Bickle. All those in favor? Thank you. 9.2, 46/2021. Recommendation from Works and Engineering, July 6, 2021. Drinking Water Quality Management System, 2020 Management Review. Have a mover and a seconder, please.
Actually, Mr. Mayor, Mr. Deputy Mayor, we just voted on those on consent, so there's no need to work through each motion. There was no request to separate any of the particular motions, so you've just voted on each of our resolutions.
So we don't have to go through 9.3 and 9.4?
You just voted on those collectively.
Okay, thank you. Number 10, bylaws. 10.1, 43/2021. Amend bylaw 46/2004 as amended, being a bylaw to establish human resources policies regarding compensation administration policy and employment classification policy updates. Can I do all these in a bundle too?
We do not do bylaws by consent. So we'll do each bylaw individually. It gets read a first and second time. That's the first motion for each. And then at the end, once we're done all five, we'll do a motion for a third reading for all five. So for bylaws, we'll go through individually, starting with 10.1.
Okay, I have a mover and a seconder on that bylaw. Moved by Councillor Meadows, seconded by Councillor Lees. Is there any discussion? All those in favor? Thank you. 44/2021, amended bylaw 46/2004 is amended, being a bylaw to establish human resources policies regarding summer hours program policy update. I have a mover and a seconder, please. Moved by Councilor Carr, second by Councilor Bickel. Any discussion? All those in favor? Thank you. 45/2021, execution of a subdivision agreement, SU02-2018, Osaka Subdivision, County Road 65. Mover and a seconder. Moved by Councilor Lee, seconded by Councilor Bickel. Any discussion? All those in favor? Approved. 10.4/46/2021, extension renewal of temporary use bylaw, the Friends of Wesleyville Village, parts of lots 30 and 31, concession one. Mover and the seconder, please. Moved by Councilor Carr, second by Councilor Meadows. All those in favor? Thank you. That's carried. 10.5/47/2021, development agreement regarding 34 Percival Street. Mover and a seconder, please. Moved by Councilor Meadows, seconded by Councilor Bickel. Is there any discussion? All those in favor? Thank you. That's carried. Point 11, new and other business.
Actually, Mr. Deputy Mayor, at this point in time, we ask for a third reading of each of the five bylaws. So just a simple motion for a third reading of the five bylaws listed, and then we will sign them and seal them in the bylaw book.
Now, therefore, be it resolved that bylaw 43-2021, 44-2021, 45-2021, 46-2021, 47-2021 be read a third time, passed, and said bylaw be signed by the mayor and clerk, sealed with seal of the corporation, and engrossed in the bylaw. But may I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Councilor Meadows, seconded by Councilor Bickel. Thank you. All those in favor? Thank you. New and other business? Anybody have anything? 12 county updates. I have a few here. As Northumberland County begins the development of the 2022 Northumberland County budget, they want to hear from you. How would you invest next year's budget to meet the needs of the community? What programs, services, and infrastructure programs, projects matter most to you? From August 3rd to 31st, 2021, Northumberland County is inviting community members to share their thoughts on these questions and more by building their preferred budget using their new interactive budget simulation tool. To participate in the 2022 budget consultation, community members are invited to visit joinin.northumberland.ca, the county's online consultation portal, starting this Tuesday. Northumberland County 2020 annual report was released July 21st, and you can visit that at northumberland.ca 2020 annual report to read the full report. Northumberland County has seen big changes in its waste programs over the last couple of years in an effort to reach their long-term goal of 75% waste diversion from landfill. To learn more, you can view their new waste watch page by visiting northumberland.ca waste watch. Here's a reminder, residents who have disabilities that prevent you from using a blue or gray box can apply to continue to set your recycling out in clear or clear blue bags if approved. Sorting materials is still required. To learn more and to apply, visit northumberland.ca recycling, or there is a number you can call, 1-866-293-8379. A new resource is now available for those seeking housing help in our community. The Housing Help Northumberland website is a central source for information about all housing and homelessness services available to Northumberland residents. To learn more, visit housinghelp.northumberland.ca. Following County Council's endorsement of June 16th, our Northumberland Community Safety and Well-being Plan has been submitted to the province. Co-designed by an advisory committee of local agencies, this plan will guide the efforts and investments of partner agencies to address the root cause of crime and complex social issues, improving quality of life in Northumberland. To review the final report along with supporting details, you can visit northumberland.ca safety and wellbeing. And that's county update. Are there any questions about any of the foregoing or preceding? Seeing none, question period. Question of council. Brian, will you alert the public for taking questions?
Yes, thank you, Deputy Mayor. To those calling in or viewing online, now would be the time to go ahead and indicate you have a question. It's real simple to do so. The instructions are posted along with the agenda, and depending on your advice, on your device, you simply need to raise your hand. So we'll allow for some time here. And if you have a question, please indicate so now, and then we'll go ahead and unmute you and you can state your name and pose your question. So we do have one question indicated from Suzanne Stickley. So Sue, I am going to unmute you. Daphne, if you are listening in, could you go ahead and unmute Sue?
Can you hear me now?
Yes. Suzanne, welcome.
If you can't hear me now, that's fine. I will lower my hand.
Well, we can hear you. Can you hear us?
Oh, you can hear me? Well, I want to thank you very much for passing the temporary rezoning and for all the support that individuals have provided to Wesleyville. And the community has been absolutely amazing. I guess I really wanted to say thank you. But my question is, gosh, it's become very difficult to log in to your meetings, and can that be simplified?
Well, hopefully next month we won't have to log in, that we'll be doing it live.
That would be great. Thank you. I really had trouble tonight getting in.
Well, we're glad you got through, and thank you, and thank you and your group for all you do.
Thank you.
Have a good evening.
Good evening.
Any other questions, Brian?
There is no indication of any further questions, Mr. Deputy Mayor.
Okay, seeing none. Confirmatory bylaw 14.148/2021 to confirm the proceedings of the council meeting of August 3rd, 2021. May I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Councillor Meadows, seconded by Councillor Lees. All those in favor? That's great. Okay.